don't give a bleep if Team Crawford got mad at me. This business is not about getting mad. This business is about facts and the reality of the situation.
Renee Box Young, man, what's going on? Thank you so much for the, man, the subscribers, those who have been with me since day one, those who have been tuning in, checking out my videos, you know, tuning into my lives, collaborating, sharing your opinions. You know, we are one community. It's all for the love of the sport of boxing. It's all for the love of you guys. I thank you guys so much. Those, you know, who have been tuning in lately and recently and since day one, man, all you guys, you know, thank you so much, man. Let's get right to it. The Athletic Boxing, this is the official, you know, Twitter account, whatever, right? Link in the description. Man, let's look at the quote, man. I mean, I just went live, talked about this, you know what I'm saying? But about the Beverly Hills thing, he said, you know, I'll buy a house with all the money I lost with Terence Crawford. But look what he said in details with other things he said concerning the same situation, man. It says, Bob Arum, right? He says, I don't give a, you know, I keep it clean. I don't give a manure. if Team Crawford got mad at me, this business is not about getting mad. This business is about facts and the reality of the situation. He sounded mad to me. Didn't you hear him a moment ago? I'm just kidding. Arum said, what did I say that was wrong? I'll show him how much we've lost on his fights. Okay, now, I just want to stop on that paragraph right there, okay? That's a quote from Bob Arum, okay? This right here. So, you know, whether you're a boss, whether you're an entrepreneur, CEO, whatever you want to call it, right? You know, Bob Arum, obviously, you know, being a promoter of Top Rank, you know, the owner of Top Rank. Dude, that's just wrong, man. I mean, I talked about it recently on the live, you know, Box Flash Live, Box Talking News. Those who tuned in know what I mentioned there, that's a spit in Crawford's face. I mean, yeah, you don't get mad, I understand, but that's just not the way to talk to your team. Talk to your team, you know? That's not how you talk to your team, you know what I'm saying? It's totally disrespectful, you know? Personally, I'm a leader, you know, where I work in a couple things, couple areas, in academia also, and I don't talk about my inferiors, you know, hierarchy. If you're above somebody, I mean, it's just not the right thing to talk down or, you know, talk disrespectful towards your team or your inferiors or superiors, whatever the situation is. And Bob Arum, man, I mean, I don't know if it's arrogance or just all due respect to him, you know what I'm saying, with his age, but I don't know, man. I don't know. I understand. He's a businessman. He crunches numbers and stuff like that, but I don't know, man. And then, okay, he continues to say, man, right here, again, if we did this fight with Spence and put our money in for half of the risk and Crawford wins and Heyman wants to sign him, be my guest for Christ's sake. Okay, I don't, you know. In other words, I am not going to go in my pocket anymore for Terence Crawford. Wow. Wow. Okay, I said this before, and you guys know it. You know, as far as with the news and this whole, the evolution of what's going on between Bob and Crawford. Bob Arum, since a long time ago, since the Crawford con fight, that, you know, that Bud Crawford isn't pay-per-view material. He's not pay-per-view material. And that's kind of a big sign that, you know, I guess Bud isn't pulling in the numbers that Arum wants. He's a businessman. I get it. You know what I'm saying? I understand that point of view. But, I mean, the way... And you know, how we talked about recently, he could have bought a house in the Beverly Hills with all the money he's throwing away with Crawford. Crawford really put himself in a bad situation. You know, he has received a lot of criticism from the boxing community, and it doesn't mean that they're hating on Crawford. And Crawford kind of looks at it like that when you go back to the post-press conference of the Bud versus Brooke fight. He talked about that, you know what I'm saying, that he's not going to do interviews for people who hate on him. And in his viewpoint, it's kind of like hating, but I don't see it really as hating. I mean, a lot of the community is not hating on Crawford. I mean, we definitely, and I include myself, you know what I'm saying, I have criticized Crawford, but I love his skills. I love watching him fight, but you know what I'm saying, he has found himself in a difficult situation by re-signing his contract or whatever, right, to Top Rank and extending, you know, his stay with Bob Arum and Top Rank, and he's been getting the opponents that he's been getting. He's been promoted, if at all, if he has gotten any promotion. You know, very little promotion from Top Rank, and the types of fights he's getting, it's just not up to the, you know, status and, you know, caliber fighting that and talent that Crawford gives and provides for Top Rank. you know, speaking as an employee, I guess you can say, right? Crawford is working for Bob Arum. I mean, it is what it is. And I understand Arum's viewpoint, but you shouldn't be so cold like that. I mean, in other words, he's like, get the heck out of here. In other words, he's saying, bud, get out of here. I don't want you anymore. I don't want you anymore. And you know, Crawford should have seen this. His team should have seen this before he re-signed the top rank. They should have seen this with previous immaculate fighters that have been with top rank, historically speaking. Why did he re-sign, and why didn't his team tell Terence not to re-sign? That's the root of the problem here. And look at what it's getting to. Look at what this is getting to. I mean, I just saw this quote and I was like, wow, this is just horrible. You know what I'm saying? Manny Pacquiao, you know, he was on top rank, same situation. You know what I'm saying? Look at Manny Pacquiao. I think that's enough said just with the name alone, you guys. You know, he left top rank. What? Floyd Mayweather. Do I have to say any more? You guys already know. Mikey Garcia. Andy Ruiz, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you have great, amazing fighters that were on top rank, and they left. They knew. They saw the writing on the wall, you know what I'm saying? But Crawford, I mean, let's continue here. It says here, I don't have, quote, this is a quote, Bob Arum, I don't have to make a lot of money with him on this Spence fight, but I know I'll break even or make a couple dollars. Wow. And they said, I'm no longer in the business of losing money on Terence Crawford. Excuse me. Now, excuse me, you guys. Now, you guys already know, I mean, well, as according to sources, right, or whatever is being said around there, that this contract is apparently until October 2021. Do you guys actually see Terence Crawford staying until 2021? That's a long time. And I said this, you know, before that, it's a long time considering the situation that Crawford is in right now and considering the situation and how Bob Arum is talking about Bud. This is just a horrible situation, you guys. In other words, I repeat, Bob Arum is saying, get out of here, Terence Crawford. I don't want you here anymore. I don't want you here anymore. Man, what's Terence going to do? And by the time I post this video up, I mean, there'll probably be a response on Terence Crawford and what he's going to do. He has to get the heck out of top rank as soon as possible. I mean, I just saw this right now, and it's just like, this is just horrible. But it boils down to that, you guys, ladies and gentlemen. His team, BOMAC, I mean, I respect these guys, but why didn't they see this before he re-signed to top rank, man? I mean, I just want to make this video quick, man. What are your opinions? What are your thoughts? Go ahead and comment, you know, down below in the comment section. You know, if there are any new listeners, you know, go ahead and listen. I'm sorry, go ahead and subscribe. Go ahead and, you know, share this. I'm kind of at a loss for words of the surprise, you know what I'm saying? It's quite cold. The business world is a cold world, but I mean, you don't have to be so cold. You can be respectful about it, especially look at Terence Crawford, you guys. I'm saying, look at the amazing skill set of Crawford, his talent, blah, blah, blah. His accolades in other divisions, and the welterweight division, not necessarily, in my opinion, right? But I mean, he's an amazing guy, you know, great fighter. And for Bob to speak about him like that, that's cold. That's cold. So it is what it is, man. Renee Boxing, thank you guys so much for your support. Love you guys, man. Until next one, peace out, fam.